Back on the show is the headliner, the CES 48 headliner, Greg Rebello, is going to be taking on Travis Wiuff. Greg, what's going on? How are you?
This is it, man. I'm doing great. You know what I mean? Had a long weekend, so I got some good rest yesterday and watched the Patriots game, and here we are.
Yeah, it was a pretty great weekend there for the New England guys, obviously going 3-for-3. We almost went 3-for-4, or 4-for-4, I should say, with Bissett, but you know, he had a tough short-notice fight there.
I still thought he won. I thought he won the first and the third, but it was a good fight, a good experience for him. You know, and, yeah. And he was, you know, he wasn't. I talked to him afterwards. He was in the locker room with us, and you know, he was happy. Not gonna say he was just happy to be there, but you know what I mean. I think he knows that he fought really well, and it was a good redemption for himself coming off the contender fight. So.
It was a great card, and you know, I was mentioning this to you off air. Lots of cameos by Greg Rebello on the broadcast. Were the phone blowing up,
three times, dude.
Were people messaging you on your phone and stuff while this is all going on, saying, "Hey, we saw you"? Because I saw you in the broadcast at least twice. It was great.
Of course, but what they were doing is they were Snapchatting me and putting the Michael Jordan crying meme on my face. So that's pretty much all I got, yeah.
That's good, man. That's awesome. How did this all come together with the main event fight? Because, you know, Bissett was supposed to headline this card against Jamal Emmers, and then they announced, you know, you're fighting Travis Wiuff, which is kind of an interesting opponent. How did you find out about the fight?
Well, so, you know, CES, I was actually going to be fighting on a later date. I know they were working on, you know, because I don't think Lion Fights re-signed with Access. So CES and LFA are going to be getting a lot more dates, you know. So I think they were working on a later February date. So I told them, I was like, you know, I want to be on that one. And then I think it didn't work out. So they pushed it back another month. And I was still training. I never stopped training. You know, I always spar once a week. You know what I mean? I don't do a ton of rounds, but I just do it just to keep my timing sharp and to keep myself in shape. And I always grapple and I always train, you know, because you never know. You know what I mean? I took this fight on 3 weeks' notice, but I'm good. I sparred 5-5s, you know, a few times already, and I'm good. I'm in good shape. So, you know, they called me and they were like, listen, Bissett signed with the UFC. We need you. You know what I mean? Can you step up and take a big fight? And I was like, yeah, you know, get me the guy and, you know, get me who you want. And Tyson and Pat Sullivan and Jimmy Jr., worked on a few different guys, and they wanted to bring somebody big in and somebody that would, you know, a lot of people would know. And Travis Wiuff, I think, was perfect. You know, I think he fits that slot really well, and it's a good main event, I think, you know.
Did you ever feel like you were going to fight someone like him? Because this kind of came out of the blue. Travis has fought for, it seems like, every promotion except for CES, so it's kind of crazy that he was, you know, ended up fighting you.
And that's the thing, too. You got to think, like, I have a good record. I have a lot of good finishes, but you know, you need that good, familiar big name to beat. You know what I mean? Because people can look up down my record and they're not going to be too familiar with a lot of the guys. You know, a lot of the guys I beat are really tough, and a lot of them I think are better than Travis, but a lot of, you know, that Travis is that really big name to go on the resume, and he's really tough. He looks like Brock Lesnar kind of, you know, so it's, I think it's a good fight. It's a good matchup. I like it, you know?
Yeah, and obviously, I mean, he's got the experience here. He's had, what, 96 fights or something like that, which is so rare to see in MMA.
Honestly, after the fight, I'm going to be like, listen, like, did you fight, like, once a week, like, every Friday, Saturday? Like, how did you get this? It's crazy.
Yeah, and, I mean, he fought in the UFC in the early days, like, well, not too early, but he fought, you know, Hanato Babalu Sobral, and he fought, I think, Jason Lambert. Like, he's fought some, you know, some guys, like, in the mid-2000s there, and so you know, obviously he's been around the block. But here's the crazy thing heading into this fight. I mean, he hasn't fought since October 2016. It's been a bit of a while. Do you feel like the layoff and his age, it's going to kind of impact him in this fight?
Well, the thing is, again, he's had 96 fights.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So he's used to it.
I think he's used to it. You know what I mean? I don't know. I haven't looked like at his record and all that stuff. So I don't know how many, if he's ever taken like large breaks in between fights. I'm assuming not. I know he had a fight fall through.
Yeah,
so
with
I'm
Wes
sure
Sims. He was supposed to fight Wes Sims.
Wes Sims. Yeah. So I don't think it's going to be a big deal. Listen, if you've had 96 fights, I think you've kind of been there before. You know what
right,
I mean?
Yeah.
So I don't think he's going to be worried about that.
How's training camp going? And I guess it must be pretty good with the fact that you have, you know, a lot of guys that just fought on the Boston card. I know they're smaller than you, but obviously you're training with some of those guys.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You know, I go to Lozon's MMA on every Saturday, and me and Calvin would get working after all the training's over. But, you know, I get to train with Mike Rodriguez every Saturday, and Lorenzo Keynes, who's another training partner who nobody even knows of, who's, you know, he's a big reason that Mike Rodriguez and I do well on the local shows. He's a big heavyweight and a good training partner for both of us. So I get to train with them. Joe Lozon always comes and helps us out with, like, ground stuff. And, you know, so Wednesday, Saturdays, I get to go there in the morning, train with Calvin, train with Rob, you know what I mean, watch over those guys sparring and stuff like that. And Kyle Bochniak, too, was always there. Matt Bissett actually came in a few times. So we had, like, the who's who of guys around New England at Lozon's on Saturday morning. So it was pretty sweet. But yeah, training camp's been going great. I have Fabio Strant and Tommy Davis that are both on this card as well, CES. So I got them on this card. They're in the undercard making their pro debuts, both of them. And they're guys you're going to be looking out for. You're going to be knowing who they are. And they're both bigger guys, so I always train with them because I was helping them getting ready for their fights, you know. So I was basically in a training camp, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and you know, having that experience last weekend, you know, in Boston at UFC 220 and having all your, you know, teammates and friends winning, do you sort of feed off that energy heading into this fight? I know it's, you know, a week or two away, but it's still it's still pretty good.
Yeah. Well, no, it's very motivating to see how other guys do things, you know what I mean? We're in the locker room with Ngannou, you know, DC was in the next locker room over. So it's cool to see how guys kind of, you know, you can tell the guy's kind of, you know, you can tell the DC's like really amped up the fight. You can see that, I wouldn't say he's nervous, but you know what I mean? You can hear him talking to himself and yelling to himself. So it's cool to see that the best guys in the world kind of go through the same thing that you do. You know what I mean? Because I do the same thing in the locker room. So it's pretty cool to see all the guys and to be able to talk to them. And yeah, it was fun, man. It was a great experience.
Is there any more urgency in this fight to sort of get the finish? I mean, you always go for the finish. It's not like you're, you know, trying to get paid by the hour. Hey, it's a little Cam here. How's it going, Cam?
He always has to make an appearance on your show.
No,
man,
it's perfect. It's great. It's good. He's sure getting so big. I've been following along on his growth by on your Instagram stories. So it's just crazy how big he's getting. How's it going, Cam?
Say hi.
Look at this. He's already taking shots at me like his dad.
He is.
That's great. Yeah, I mean, do you feel like there's sort of more of an urgency to get the finish here, just with the fact that, I mean, you've been so close to the UFC so many times. I feel like a win here, especially over a vet, would get you in there.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I always go for the finish. You know what I mean? I think I'm like 8-2 over my last 10, and I finished all of those fights. You know what I mean? I always go for the finish. You know what I mean? I don't expect anything less. I don't train for anything less. You know what I mean? I think a lot of people probably think because I have a lot of first-round finishes that I just go out there and go for the kill and I don't have cardio. You know, I always put the work in. I always, you know, if I'm fighting 3 rounds or 5 rounds, I always do more. You know what I mean? I'm always ready to go distance. I just, you know, my boxing coach, dude, Dave Keefe, man, he's the man. He makes sure that, you know what I mean, I always have power, and I've always had power for 5 rounds. And I give him the most of the credit, you know what I mean, because he always makes sure I'm in shape no matter what, man. So I'm not worried about going 5 rounds, but I'm going to get the finish regardless.
For sure. I appreciate you playing interference here, too. You know, the Contender Series, it sounds like they're returning in July. You know, would you wait until then to fight again, or would you get another fight for CES? What's sort of the game plan after this, assuming all goes well and you get a finish?
Yeah, no, I mean, yeah, obviously I have a tough task ahead of me. I'm one of those guys, not only am I humble, but I never get ahead of myself because you see what happens when these guys start to get ahead of themselves. So, you know, next week I got a tough fight in front of me. But, yeah, all goes well. I want to stay busy. You know, I fought in the last, this will be in 13 months, my fifth fight.
That's right. Yeah, it has been a lot.
So I always stay busy. I always stay busy.
Excellent. We got to talk some hockey, obviously, when you and I chat. The Bruins doing quite well this season. What's sort of the outlook for the rest of the season? There's no major injuries or anything like that. They seem to be doing pretty well.
No, they've actually, so David Backes had that, what did he have, that like colon surgery? They thought he had colon cancer or something, which was crazy. And he came back quick, man. And not only, he's a huge leader. He's an older guy. He's a big leader in the locker room. So he's come back. David Krejci's come back. So we have a, look at me, playing dad. This is what happens.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I know it is, yeah.
We've had a lot of big injuries, but all of our guys have come back. They're all healthy. And I think the biggest thing going in the playoffs with us is we're so young, man. We got so many guys that are fresh out of college, like DeBrus, Corrali. All those guys are super young. Anders Bjork's going to be back, Pasternak. So I think, you know, you're going to see a lot of these teams with all the veterans going to kind of run out of steam, man. I think it's – hockey's one of them sports that's – I mean, how many times have you seen an 8 seed go into the cup? L.A. did it like a few years back and won it. You know, it's kind of like who's healthy going into the playoffs. You know what I mean? That's it, in any sport, it's like that, but hockey for sure, man. And the Bruins, they're healthy and they got a lot of young legs. And their defense has actually been surprising. I think in the trade deadline, you're going to see us pick up a winger rather than a defenseman.
Okay, interesting. Well, I was going to say, and that makes it kind of dangerous for other teams with the fact you have a young team. There's no expectation to, you know, go far, whereas some of these other teams, you know, the pressure is on them, you know, like a Pittsburgh or something where they need to go out there and, you know, perform really well. So it could be interesting. So they're doing better
than the Canucks, James. Well, so,
that's a given. I mean,
so our Twitter wins, I'm always going to win.
Two things I hope don't happen to the trade. I'd like to see Jim Benning relieved of his duties. It's time for a change. The rumor is they're looking at Ken Holland in Detroit because there's a BC connection there. So that would be interesting. And then I don't want us to get Evander Kane. Like, Buffalo is just as bad as we are, but Kane's from Vancouver. So, you know, there's all these rumblings that they might get him. I don't know. Just get rid of Louis Erickson's contract and Jim Benning and I'll be happy. So.
Louis Erickson's that's a rough one, man.
Someone just did a stat the other day. I forget what it was. It was like his first 100 games, and I think he has like 40 points or something. It's just it's awful. One of the worst.
Yeah, for what he's taking, of course. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I'll tell you what's going to be good, though. CES 48 coming up here February 2nd. It's going to be live on Access TV. Greg, I always appreciate the time, especially on Daddy Duty. It's very much appreciated. Just remind people where they can get a hold of you on social media, and if you got any sponsors or shout-outs, the floor is yours, man.
My Twitter account is GRebello73, and my Instagram is GRibsMMA23. Don't ask me how I got any of those numbers or anything. They make no sense. But, yeah, that's how you find me. And, you know, as always, man, it's my teams, Triforce and CL Tong and Lozons. And my manager, Tyson Chardier, man, the guy, he does a lot for us and the fighters. And he's the one who, you know, he gets all my sponsors like Triumph and Dethrone. Those guys always take care of me on fight night, and I really appreciate it, man. So, and I appreciate you, and I'm happy to see all your success, man. Seeing your name all over the place, and I'm basically on the undercard of James Lynch shows now. I feel like.
Are you crazy? I make time even on vacation here. You know, I'm in Mexico. I could be out on the beach right now. You know, I had to tell my wife that rather than being at the pool with her, I wanted to talk to Greg Rebello. So there you go.
Yeah, it makes me feel good, dude. As I'm sitting here in the freezing cold weather.